fluid. Recommended tests for pleural fluid includes routine test, which includes gross examination. Chemical examination includes protein, glucose, pleural fluid to serum protein ratio, pleural fluid to serum lactate dehydrogenase ratio, and cholesterol level. Cell counts, including total and differential count, cytology, culture, and gram stain. Additional tests can include enzymes like amylase and lactate dehydrogenase, lipid measurement for chylus effusion, tumor markers like CEA as found in metastatic lung or breast carcinoma, immunological studies like rheumatoid arthritis factor, antinuclear antibody factor, and complement levels. Normal pleural fluid is a transudate and has the following characteristic: clear ultrafiltrate of plasma that originates from parietal pleura, has a pH of 7.6 to 7.64, protein content of less than 1 to 2 grams per deciliter, fewer than 1,000 white blood cells per cubic millimeter, glucose content similar to that of plasma, lactate dehydrogenase less than 50% of the plasma levels. A buildup of serous fluid is called an effusion. The effusion could be due to increased capillary permeability, increased capillary hydrostatic pressure, decreased plasma oncotic pressure, or decreased lymphatic reabsorption. Classifying the fluid as transudate or exudate helps in diagnosis. Transudates are seen with systemic disorders like congestive heart failure, nephrotic syndrome, and hepatic cirrhosis, whereas exudates are associated with localized infection, malignancy, trauma or infarction, or immunological disorders, for example, SLE or rheumatoid disease. Chylus exudates are associated with rupture or blockage of thoracic duct. The table shown shows you the criteria used to differentiate transudates from exudates. Appearance in the transudate is clear, colorless, trocholoid, while in exudate it's cloudy, purulent, or hemorrhagic. Specific gravity of transudate is less than 1.015. In exudate, it is more than 1.015. Total protein is less than 3 gram per deciliter in a transudate and more than 3 grams per deciliter in exudate. The fluid protein to serum protein ratio is less than 0.5 in a transudate and more than 0.5 in exudate. Pleural fluid lactate dehydrogenase is less than 2/3 the upper limit of normal serum in a transudate and more than 2/3 the upper limit of normal serum lactate dehydrogenase in exudate. Pleural fluid to serum lactate dehydrogenase ratio is less than 0.6 in a transudate and more than 0.6 in an exudate. The pleural fluid cholesterol is less than 45 mg per deciliter in transudate, more than 45 mg per deciliter in an exudate. Pleural fluid or serum cholesterol ratio is less than 0.3 and more than 0.3 in an exudate. Interpreting pleural fluid. Color: pale, clear, straw-colored fluid is a transudative fluid, while a turbid, cloudy, presence of clot is exudative fluid. A reddish color is seen in trauma, malignancy, or pulmonary infarct. Chemical examination. Protein measurement is not very useful. Decreased glucose levels are seen in rheumatoid pleuritis and few cases of malignancy, tuberculosis, and bacterial infections. Lactate levels are increased in bacterial and tubercular pleural infection. Lactate dehydrogenase levels rise in pleural inflammation. Low pH and low glucose level seen in parapneumonic effusion, rheumatoid pleuritis, and malignant effusion. Cell counts. Total white blood cell count more than 1,000 per microliter suggests an exudate and infective etiology. A differential count with more than 50% neutrophils is seen in bacterial pneumonia, pulmonary infarction, and early tuberculosis. A differential count with more than 50% lymphocytes is seen in tubercular, viral, malignant, rheumatoid pleuritis, and SLE. A differential count with more than 10% eosinophils can be seen in pulmonary infarct, trauma, or rheumatological disease. RBC count more than 1 lakh per microliter is suggestive of malignant trauma or pulmonary infarct. Cytology. Mesothelial cells are reactive cells commonly seen in pleural fluid, which are shed by the pleura. They are seen in inflammatory, rheumatoid, and malignant conditions. Lupus erythematous cells or LE cells can be seen in some cases of effusion from systemic lupus erythematosus. Pericardial fluid. Normally, 10 to 50 milliliters of fluid is present in the pericardial space around the heart. The process of fluid formation is same as described earlier. Recommended tests for pericardial effusion are routine tests, which include gross examination, chemical examination for protein and glucose, cell count, which includes total and differential count, cytology, culture, and gram stain. The additional tests include enzymes like adenosine deaminase for tubercular pericarditis, lipid to differentiate chylous and pseudochylous effusions. Interpretation of pericardial fluid. Gross appearance. Large volume, which is more than 350 ml, is seen in malignancy or uremia. Turbid fluid suggests infection or malignancy. Blood-like fluid indicates either a hemorrhagic effusion or blood from the heart chamber. Check the hematocrit, it will be same as that of venous blood and will clot in case of blood from heart chamber. Chemical examination. Protein levels have very little use. Glucose level less than 40 mg per deciliter can be seen in bacterial, tubercular, rheumatic, and malignant effusions. Adenosine deaminase activity is increased in tubercular pericarditis. Microbiological examination. Gram stain may be positive in 50% of bacterial pericarditis, whereas culture may be positive in up to 80% cases. Acid fast stain may be positive in up to 50% cases of tubercular pericarditis. Cell count. Total white blood cell count more than 10,000 per microliter suggests bacterial, tuberculous, or malignant pericarditis. Cytology. The pap or GIMSA stained smears may show presence of malignant cells, commonest being metastatic cells from breast or lung malignancy. Ascetic fluid. The normal peritoneal fluid is less than 50 milliliters of transudative fluid in the mesothelial lined peritoneal cavity, which is an ultrafiltrate of plasma across capillary walls. When there is excessive accumulation of free fluid in the peritoneal cavity, it is called ascites, and the fluid received in the laboratory is called ascetic fluid. Some common causes for ascites are transudative ascites as seen in congestive cardiac failure, cirrhosis, and nephrotic syndrome. Exudative ascites seen in infections, malignancies, traumatic, or pancreatitis. The classification into transudates and exudates is not well defined for ascetic fluid. Sample. Ideally, 50 to 100 ml of fluid should be sent for examination. The recommended tests for ascetic fluid include routine tests, which involves gross examination, chemical examination for protein, glucose, serum ascites albumin concentration gradient, cell count, including total and differential count, cytology, culture and gram stain. The additional tests could be enzymes like alkaline phosphatase to check intestinal injuries, lactate dehydrogenase in patients with suspected malignant effusion, creatinine and urea to differentiate peritoneal fluid from urine, ammonia levels in suspected cases of perforated peptic ulcer, ruptured appendix or intestinal strangulation. Interpreting ascetic fluid. Based on gross examination, pale yellow and clear fluid is suggestive of a transudate. Cloudy or turbid fluid due to presence of leukocytes or tumor cells is suggestive of an exudate. Green-yellow color could be due to perforation of gastrointestinal tract or the biliary tract. Blood-tinged or grossly bloody fluid could mean traumatic tap or malignancy, tuberculosis, or intra-abdominal organ rupture in trauma. Cell count. There is no standardized ascetic fluid cell count. Generally accepted cutoff limits of normal is less than 250 leukocytes per cubic millimeter. Cell count of more than 500 cells per cubic millimeter with 70% polymorphs is highly suggestive of spontaneous bacterial peritonitis. Whereas in tubercular ascites, there is a lymphocytic predominance. Chemical examination. The serum ascites albumin gradient, or the SAAG, is superior to total protein concentration to differentiate cirrhosis as a cause. It is calculated as serum albumin minus ascetic albumin is equal to serum ascites albumin gradient. Low SAAG of less than 1.1 gram per deciliter is seen in ascites due to infection or malignancy. High SAAG, more than 1.1 gram per deciliter, is seen in portal hypertension-related ascites and liver cirrhosis and congestive heart failure. Amylase. Normally in ascites, the amylase is similar to that of serum amylase. Increase of more than 3 times can be seen with acute pancreatitis or pancreatic pseudocyst, gastroduodenal perforation, acute mesenteric vein thrombosis, or intestinal necrosis can also cause high amylase levels. Glucose has little value. In uncomplicated ascites, it is usually similar to serum levels. In late spontaneous bacterial peritonitis, ascetic glucose levels can drop to as low as 0 mg per deciliter secondary to bacterial consumption. Low levels of glucose are also seen in 30 to 60% cases of tubercular peritonitis. Alkaline phosphatase. Greater than 10 units per liter is useful in predicting hollow visceral injury. Also helps differentiate between primary and secondary bacterial peritonitis. Lactate dehydrogenase activity is often increased in malignant effusion. An ascetic fluid to serum lactate dehydrogenase ratio greater than 0.6. Adenosine deaminase levels are used to identify patients with tuberculosis in endemic areas using a cutoff of 30 international units per liter. Tumor markers like CEA, CA125, CA199 are used to differentiate different intra-abdominal tumors. Culture and gram stain. Culture should be obtained by inoculating blood culture bottle at the bedside. This has shown to improve the sensitivity to at least 80% compared with 50% for conventional culture methods. Gram stains are rarely positive as the concentration of organism is not high enough. Cytology. Cytology is only partially helpful to diagnose malignant ascites, as most intra-abdominal cancers do not frequently metastasize to peritoneum. 100% sensitivity is found only in diagnosing peritoneal carcinomatosis. Liquid-based cytology and thin layer preparations are superior to standard cytological preparations. Note, negative cytology does not rule out cancers. Synovial fluid. Synovial fluid is the fluid in joints and is an imperfect ultrafiltrate of plasma combined with hyaluronic acid produced by synovial cells. It is examined for undiagnosed effusions to differentiate between inflammatory and infectious disorders like septic arthritis and for crystalline arthropathies like gout. Ideally, the specimen is divided into three parts, depending upon the quantity of effusion fluid aspirated and the clinical requirement. Sample can be divided into EDTA tube for total and differential counts, blood culture bottle for aerobic and anaerobic cultures, heparinized tubes for biochemistry and cytology. If malignancy, fungal or mycobacterial infection is suspected, maximum amount of fluid should be submitted to maximize yield. Please note, cytology samples can be stored up to 12 hours under refrigeration. Normal synovial fluid has the following characteristics. Grossly, it is straw-colored, clear and moderately viscous. Proteins are 1 to 3 gram per deciliter, which is approximately one-third the plasma level. Glucose is 70 to 110 milligram per deciliter, similar to plasma levels. Uric acid is 2 to 8 milligram per deciliter, again similar to plasma level. Hyaluronate is 0.3 to 0.4 grams per deciliter. Cellular content is 0 to 150 cells per cubic millimeter. They include white blood cells, occasionally red blood cells, and some synovial lining cells. The recommended tests for synovial fluid include routine tests, which involves gross examination for color and clarity, cell count for total and differential counts, gram stain and bacterial culture, chemical examination for glucose and protein levels, crystal examination. The additional tests could be fungal and acid fast stains, lactate levels, lipid levels, serum synovial fluid glucose differential. Interpretation of synovial fluid. Based on gross appearance, colorless to pale yellow indicate normal synovial fluid. Straw to yellow color can be seen in non-inflammatory and inflammatory condition. Yellow, brown or greenish color indicates septic or infective arthritis. Reddish color indicates traumatic tap, traumatic effusion or hemarthrosis or malignancy. Clarity. Clear or transparent fluid is a normal synovial fluid. Turbid or cloudy indicates inflammatory, infective or hemorrhagic conditions. Chylous fluid appears milky even after centrifugation. Viscosity. Synovial fluid is viscous due to presence of hyaluronate. A string test can be used to evaluate the level of synovial fluid viscosity. After removing the needle or cap from the syringe, synovial fluid is expressed into a test tube, one drop at a time. Normal synovial fluid will form a string approximately 5 cm long before breaking. In addition, the fluid may cling to the side of the test tube rather than running down the side to the bottom. Synovial fluids with poor viscosity will form shorter strings, and it can be seen with inflammatory conditions. Biochemical tests. Glucose. The synovial fluid to serum level glucose difference is examined. Normal difference is less than 10 mg per deciliter. 20 to 60 mg per deciliter difference is seen in septic arthritis. Protein. The normal level is 1.38 grams per deciliter. Increased levels may be seen in inflammatory conditions. Lactate dehydrogenase. Lactate dehydrogenase can be elevated in synovial fluid in rheumatoid arthritis, infectious arthritis, and gout. Lactate. Up to 10 times increase is associated with septic arthritis. Cell count. The normal limit for total white blood cell count is 150 to 200 cells per microliter. The normal differential count is 20% neutrophils, 15% lymphocytes, and 65% monocytes and macrophages. Differential with 75% neutrophils can be seen in inflammatory, rheumatoid arthritis, and gout. Differential with increased lymphocytes can be seen with early rheumatoid arthritis, chronic infection, and collagen disorders. Crystal examination. Synovial fluid is evaluated under polarized light to recognize the presence of crystals and to distinguish the type of crystals that are present. Needle-like monosodium urate crystals are associated with gout, and calcium pyrophosphate crystals are associated with pseudogout. Gram stain and culture. Gram stain is always performed for synovial fluid because of high sensitivity. Ziehl-Nielsen stain has low sensitivity for acid-fast bacilli in synovial fluid. A synovial biopsy is recommended for suspected tuberculous arthritis. Synovial fluid culture has high sensitivity for non-gonococcal joint infections. Fungal and mycobacterial cultures are performed only in clinically suspicious cases. There is a lot of overlap between the various joint diseases, except for specific result of Gram stain, culture, and crystal. Other findings need to be interpreted in context with the clinical picture. A table showing the synovial fluid findings as per the disease category can be seen on the screen. The normal fluid will have clear to straw-colored appearance, 1 to 150 cells per microliter, neutrophil percentage of less than 25%, absent RBC, and 0 to 10 mg per deciliter difference between the synovial and the plasma glucose level. The group 1 or the non-inflammatory group of diseases have yellow transparent fluid with less than 3000 cell count, less than 30% neutrophils, absent RBC, and a difference of 0 to 10 mg per deciliter from the plasma glucose. The group 2 or the inflammatory group, the fluid is yellow, cloudy, and turbid, with 3,000 to 75,000 cells per microliter, more than 50% neutrophils, absent RBCs, and a difference of 0 to 40 mg per deciliter. The group 3, or the infectious group, has a synovial fluid which is yellow and purulent, with a high WBC count of 50,000 to 200,000, more than 90% neutrophils, RBCs may be present, and the synovial plasma glucose difference of 20 to 100 mg per deciliter. The group 5 or the hemorrhagic group has red, brown or xanthochromic color of the synovial fluid, 50 to 10,000 white blood cells, less than 50% neutrophils, presence of plenty of RBCs, and synovial plasma glucose difference of 0 to 20 mg per deciliter.